What's up, champions? Welcome to another video. So in this video, I want to show you a full calisthenics bodyweight leg routine. So this is the routine I currently use myself. So it's appropriate for any intermediate or advanced level athlete. If you're a beginner, I'm going to show you how to modify it. So you can also start with this routine. So this is a phenomenal routine for developing strength and muscle, but also for developing jumping ability. So if in the future, maybe you want to learn some flips or you want to start with parkour, this is the thing to be doing. So also all of my students in the mentorship program, I'm currently using something like this to develop good and springy legs. So this is a routine to be done about twice a week, or if you're really involved into leg training, so maybe you're training parkour or something so professionally, so you really need to do a lot of leg training, in that case you can also later on do it 3 times per week. But if you're just starting, about twice a week is gonna be perfect. So enough talk, let's start with a routine. Boom. All right, so first we're gonna start with the warm-up. So this is the warm-up I've been using for years and it's simply amazing. So basically we have a wooden stick and you try to catch it as close to the floor as possible in all sorts of different positions. So here you see me going for the pike position. You can do it in the lunge position or in the squat as well. So we're gonna do about 3 sets of 1 minute to warm up the legs. Then I usually proceed with some arch-ups. So basically I really love to warm up my lower back before going to some jumping. So if you have the possibility of doing that, then make sure to do so. And then we proceed with warming up the calves because we're gonna do some jumping. So we gotta start bouncing a little bit. So you can just do it on spot or back and forth and left to right as well to warm up the calves and the Achilles before we do some jumping. Very, very important. Make sure not to skip. It's also about 3 sets of 1 minute. So then we proceed with the box jumps. So this is the first exercise. Really make sure to kind of be very relaxed and then explode on the box as high as you possibly can. So this table right here is not my max, but I'm definitely giving all I got to jump as high as I possibly can. So 4 to 8 sets of about 6 to 8 reps. So 4 to 8 sets, start with 4, then progress to 8 and about 6 to 8 repetitions. Jump as high as you possibly can. So this is the first exercise, and make sure also to land quietly. Very, very important. If it's quiet, it's good. If it's loud, it's not good. So I would actually love for you to start on the stairs. So you see me, I actually filmed it right because of that, because doing it on the stairs is just phenomenal because you're able to walk back down. So there are so many injuries of Achilles when they actually jump down on a CrossFit competition. They jump down from the box and several of the guys tore their Achilles. I think there was 5 guys. So really make sure you walk back down. That's the safest thing possible. And as you learn to do some drop jumps as well, you can jump down as well. But really make sure to start incorporating that very slowly. So we jump, we land as quietly as we possibly can, stay on spot, catch the balance, and then repeat for 6 to 8 repetitions. So here I'm going a little more in length instead of in height, which also works beautifully. And as you can see, I'm barefoot, but I've been barefoot 90% of my life. So if you're not quite so comfortable, make sure to put on some shoes, but also make sure that they have as less padding as possible. You don't want to have too much padding because then you will not have to do the job of absorbing the impact correctly. So that's why I like to use, just be barefoot for stuff like that, because just it feels better. And here also going for plyometric box jumps later on. So jumping on a step and then exploding right away to another step. So also one of the variations you can play around with. So the box jump, the first exercise, then we proceed with the squat jumps. So here not really going for height once you start, but going more for quality. So making sure you jump up symmetrically, making sure that you absorb the impact correctly and that you feel stable. And then as you progress, you can go for height. So really exploding up as much as you can. 3 to 5 sets of 8 to 12 repetitions on squat jumps. Really make sure quiet is good. And then we proceed towards the lateral jumps, so side to side jumps. These ones I really love and I've been doing them a lot in the past, so just phenomenal as well. So this is kind of the bonus exercise and this is how you start with it. So this is the beginning, kind of leaving 1 foot behind, letting the arm swing naturally, and then you jump from left to right, and then as you progress you try to do it quicker and also jumping further distance from left to right. So 3 to 5 sets, again 10 to 20 repetitions if you're ready for that one. And then we proceed with the toe squat. So basically it's a squat on your toes. So we're gonna do 3 to 5 sets of about 5 to 8 repetitions. So this one, go as deep as you feel comfortable, but it's a brilliant exercise to create bulletproof knees. You just have to make sure to implement it correctly and don't start by doing it too much. And then we'll proceed with some low gate jumps. Or if you're actually a bit more advanced, just start with the low gate jumps, because this is a beautiful progression to strengthen the quads. So start with low gate jumps and do about 10 to 20 repetitions if advanced. If not, go for a squat on the toes, 5 to 8 reps. So here you see me having a lot of fun with this one. I usually do about 30, 40 reps, just phenomenal stimulants on the quads. And again, quiet is good. And then for the hamstrings, I use a bit of a gypsy variation here. So just an old t-shirt to get some stimulants on the hamstrings as well. So just in case you ain't got the place to do some glute ham raises, so there's a beautiful progression. Just make sure to stay posterior and really focus on pulling with the hamstrings and not arching in the lower back. And then we're gonna finish with some calf work, so basically some boxers conditioning. Here I'm just using a band, and then you can do some skipping or just two leg bouncing to finish with the calves. 4 to 8 sets of about 1 minute, and as you get stronger, as you get more comfortable, you can also increase time under tension, go for 2 minutes or 3 minutes. So kind of the two legs is the basic progression, then as you get stronger, you can also do it on one leg, beautiful progression, and later on you can also just have a lot of fun with different progressions and just kind of mix it up a little bit like I'm doing right here. So this is an exercise I got from a wonderful boxing coach, Daskalo Jacob, and I just really love it. It's a whole bunch of fun. So 4 to 8 sets of about 1 minute of bouncing to finish up for the calves. Boom. All right, so that is the leg routine. Beautiful stuff for developing strong legs and also good jumping ability. So a lot of people like to leave that out. They tend to do a lot of strength training for the legs and heavy squats and deadlifts, while all that is great, but really make sure to jump, guys. So sprinting and jumping are the two things that I will definitely include in my leg training, and they're just phenomenal for leg strength, coordination, and muscle development, and also good jumping ability. So about twice per week for perfect results. Make sure to start with a little bit less volume, so a little bit less sets, and then you increase sets with the coming weeks, and you're gonna have amazing results with developing your some muscle mass in those legs and also developing your jumping ability. So that's about it for this video. I hope you enjoyed it, and really make sure, if you missed my first webinar, make sure to click the link right here below the video and sign up for the webinar. So it's happening on Wednesday and it's the final one. So if you want to hear some secrets on how to improve your muscle mass, really take it to the next level, and how to improve your strength drastically, then make sure to sign up and secure your spot. So click the link right here below the video and I'll see you at the webinar. So the final one, make sure not to miss it. I'll see you guys at the webinar. Boom. You're a champion.